Kanye West is known for his brilliant use of sampling, the art of transforming a small section of a recorded song into something completely new. For example, in the hands of Kanye, this tiny piece of Michael Jackson's PYT becomes this. Which ultimately becomes this. Like we always do with this time, I go for mine, I get to shine, now throw your hands up. And while Kanye is well known for these kinds of musical transformations, many overlook how Kanye uses samples to propel, contextualize, and enrich the larger stories told on his albums. For some, this might sound like a strange concept. How can someone tell stories using samples of old music? Well, today, I'm going to show you, and by the end of this video, I doubt you'll ever listen to Kanye West music the same way again. I'm Cole Kushner, host of Spotify's music analysis podcast, Dissect, which has two full seasons breaking down Kanye West's Yeezus and Twisted Fantasy. In this video, we're dissecting the narrative of 2013's Yeezus to show how Kanye uses samples to tell stories. Like all of Kanye's albums, Yeezus contains an overarching narrative that's based on his life at the time. And in 2013, Kanye was desperate to branch out beyond music into fashion. But after failing to find backing for his creative visions, Kanye reached a breaking point.
Or why don't you empower yourself and don't need them and do it yourself?
Halfway.
Take a few steps back.
You ain't got the answers, man. You ain't got the answers. You ain't got the answers.
This anger and frustration is what fueled the Yeezus album's aggressive, polarizing soundscape, obvious from its very opening moments. With On Sight, the story begins, and we meet the album's protagonist, Yeezus, a famous, combative, narcissistic womanizer who, inside a nightclub, gets what and who he wants when he wants it. Yeezy season approaching, fuck whatever y'all been hearing, fuck whatever y'all been wearing, a monster about to come alive again. But exactly midway through On Sight, Kanye drops an unexpected sample that sharply contrasts with the song's dissonant soundscape. These sampled lyrics, "He'll give us what we need, it may not be what we want," carry more than one meaning. On one level, Kanye is breaking the fourth wall. He knows this is the sound we want from him, but he's purposefully not giving it to us. Additional layers reveal themselves, though, when we dig into the sample source itself, which comes from the gospel ensemble Holy Name of Mary Choral Family. The song's lyrics highlight people who are frustrated that their prayers for material things aren't being answered. The moral is that God knows what's best for us and will deliver what we need, even though it's not always what we think we want. Knowing this, the lyrics read like divine commentary on the Yeezus character. This lifestyle of fast women and luxury cars isn't what he needs, which triggers the transformative journey presented on the album. The album then continues with a string of songs that express Yeezus' revolutionary ambitions. On New Slaves, he admonishes the corporations that control the population with materialism, who convince us what we want is what we need. We've all become new slaves to these corporate heads, our new masters. And Yeezus wants to do something about it. I know that we the new slaves. I see the blood on the leaves. They throwing hate at me. Want me to stay at ease. Fuck you and your corporation. Y'all niggas can't control me. But now outside the nightclub, Yeezus realizes the limitations of his celebrity status. His revolutionary message falls on deaf ears, signaling the next major sample of the album. This sample is taken from a song called Pearls in Her Hair by Hungarian band Omega. What we hear on New Slaves is sung in Hungarian, but when looking at the official English translation of what's sampled, we realize that, just like On Sight, the lyrics provide essential commentary and narrative foreshadowing. One day the sun, too tired to shine, slept in the deep, green, somber lake, and in the darkness the world did ail until she came for all our sake. Yeezus is the sun too tired to shine. His dreams of revolution have failed, and his descent into darkness is exactly what occurs in the album's next run of songs. Defeated and wounded, Yeezus drunkenly retreats to an ex-girlfriend but is rejected on the song Hold My Liquor. He then escapes into a whirlwind of sex with anonymous women on I'm In It. Then, in the emotional epic Blood on the Leaves, we finally get to the source of what's been buried beneath Yeezus' mask of machismo. Before Blood on the Leaves reveals that Yeezus had once fallen in love, but the love this woman had for Yeezus shifted to a love for the lifestyle his celebrity provided. The allure of the limelight tore the relationship apart, leaving an open wound that Yeezus has been unable to heal. And so Yeezus' revolutionary ideas aren't just socially motivated, they're personal too. This signals why Blood on the Leaves is built on a sample from Nina Simone's rendition of Strange Fruit, a historically potent song about the horrific lynchings in the American South.
Strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees.
Yeezus first mentioned the blood on the leaves on New Slaves. If we are all slaves to materialism, then what's being plundered from society is everything meaningful, our humanity, our faith in God, and the purity of love. All things Yeezus is missing in his life. Blood on the Leaves is the breakthrough moment for Yeezus as he reconciles his failed social ambitions with his failed love life. Typically in narratives, breakthrough moments lead to the resolution of the story, which is what makes the second to last track on the album all the more puzzling.
This the crazy shit in the club. Sis in the club. It's so packed.
Broken and unable to transcend on his own, Send It Up finds Yeezus back in the club, displaying the same arrogant, bombastic behavior he did on site. So what exactly is going on here? Was all that progress in vain? Well, it's here that we need to circle back to that Omega sample at the end of New Slaves, the one that spoke about a sun too tired to shine. If you recall, it was a divine figure, a woman with pearls in her hair, that would be the one that resurrected the sun. And that's exactly what happens on the album's next and final song. Bound 2 is built almost entirely on samples taken from a song called Bound by the 70s soul group Ponderosa Twins Plus One. The original song is all about the moment you first meet the girl of your dreams, the one that's different from all the rest. Lo and behold, on Bound 2, back in the club on a Thursday, Yeezus finally meets the one woman that's worth a thousand of those other girls he'd been sleeping with. By the song's second verse, Yeezus, the once womanizing chauvinist, actually talks about marriage.
Maybe we could still make it to the church steps, but first you gon' remember how to forget.
Through the arrival of this divine woman and the future Yeezus sees with her, Bound 2 pays off on all the major themes and plot points set up by the album's most prominent samples. The soul sample sound teased by Kanye in the album's first song finally arrives in full, a bright, glimmering contrast that resolves the album musically. Narratively, the gospel sample of On-Site foreshadowed God giving Yeezus what he needed, while the Omega sample of New Slaves foreshadowed a divine woman that would come to save our hero. In one fell swoop, the woman in Bound 2 resolves both plot points.
I know you're tired of loving with nobody to love.
In 2013, Kanye was frustrated by his creative constraints as an artist. But it was also during the same exact time that he had fallen in love with Kim Kardashian, his soon-to-be wife and mother of his children. Kim already had money and fame. She already had the limelight. Yeezus had found his match. He no longer needed those other women. He no longer needed the brash mask of machismo. In other words, he no longer needed Yeezus. When Kanye West was at his lowest, God gave him what he really needed. He gave him love.
Of course, being in the limelight, you know, it's difficult because there's people that you would date that would try to, you know, date you to maybe be more famous, or there's people who will want you to be less famous than you were and, you know, just not accept who you are, you know, in life. Mm-hmm. And when I would be on the phone with her, you know, even at my, you know, lowest moment, she'd give me energy and remind me of who I was. After I, you know, lost my mother, there was times I felt like, I would put my life at risk. I felt like sometimes I didn't have something to live for. Now I have, you know, two really special to live people to live for, a whole family to live for, a whole world to live for. So, yeah.
And that's the story of Yeezus. Kanye tells the story through lyrics, but builds the world through samples.